Welcome to this Geneious Biologics tutorial video on how to pre-process your Sanger antibody sequences and prep them for analysis. To start, let's look at our raw Sanger sequences. For this example, we'll be working with the forward and reverse reads from two heavy chains and two light chains. The pre-processing steps can all be found in the same dropdown. First, let's trim off the low-quality ends of the sequences. The default error probability limit is 0.05, which means that the trimming tool will continue to trim bases until further trimming only improves the error rate by less than 5%. Let's run this. When you run a job, it will appear here in the Jobs tab, with activity indicated by the spinning wheel. Once a job is completed, you can navigate directly to the results by clicking here. Now, let's batch assemble the forward and reverse reads to form contig sequences. Select all the sequences, then select Batch Assemble Sanger Sequences here. In this example, we'll be using a part of the file name to match forward and reverse reads. You can also choose to annotate consensus heterozygotes at this step. We've chosen to group consensus sequences into one document list, as well as generate individual contig sequences. Here are the results, a total of 6 documents. One is a document containing all 4 of the consensus sequences in a list, which is the document you'll annotate. One is the summary report of how many sequences were successfully assembled into contigs, and 4 are the successfully aligned and merged individual contigs. Geneious Biologics also features a tool to automatically batch assemble Sanger sequences using name schemes. You can see here that Geneious Biologics is able to parse metadata like chain type, sample information, and read direction from sequence file names using the name schemes feature. Geneious Biologics can also pair individual heavy and light chain sequences based on list position or commonality in the sequence name. In this example, you can see that there is a heavy and light chain for each clone. The heavy and light chain sequence names both include the antibody name, so we'll be matching by sequence names. Here are the results, indicated by the paired in the document title. You can see in the sequence viewer, if you hover over a sequence, it highlights the corresponding light or heavy chain that it's paired with. For more information about Geneious Biologics, visit geneious.com/biologics.